My soul fidelity in the grave, never let mercy with thy children instruction. They shall, I wonder if you go in the darkness, with thy righteousness, that man that is drop. But as for thee, unto thee, O Lord, have I cried, for the morning shall not bear come for me. Wherefore, O Lord, as I cast off the sword to the same day, the forelay of mine is troublesome to me. Yea, having been exalted, I have, I was humbled by distress. Thy fury is passed upon me, and I dare to sojourn. They came round about to my water all the day long, and rose about together. Thou shalt look afar from me, friend and neighbor, and my complaints, because my misery. O Lord God of my salvation, by day, and I cry in my night before thee, that my prayer come forth, and bow down and hear it in supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, with the head round all that he has done for me. He was gracious with all that is within me, with all that is within me. Life and corruption. Crown me with mercy and compassion, put up thy desire for the things, that you shall be renewed like peoples. The Lord confirms all with peace, mercy, pursuit, and judgment for all that have done wrong. He hath made his ways known to Moses, the sons of Israel, and his kingdom have will. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and mighty and mercy. Not in the end will he be able, neither in the eternity will he draw. Not according to our iniquities as he dealt with us, neither according to our sins as he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven and the earth, the Lord hath made the mercy prevail over them that fear him. And as far as the east is from the west, so far have you removed our iniquities from us. Light as the water and compassion upon the sun, so have you brought compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth whereof we are made, and remember the day of us. As the wind, his days are as the grass. As flower and field, so shall be blossom forth. And when the wind is passed over, the desert shall be known, and the water will come in place thereof. For the mercy of the Lord shall be turned to the earth, which turned upon the heaven and hearing, and his righteousness upon sons and sons upon them, and he himself, the remembrance of him, the Lord in heaven will prepare his throne, and his kingdom will rule over all. Bless the Lord, all ye that take his might and strength, and follow the word, to hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, be his hosts, ministers to his will. Bless the Lord, be his works, and replace his divinity. Bless the Lord, O my soul. And it replaces his divinity. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, and hear my supplication, my truth. Hearken unto me in thy righteousness, and in the judgment of my servant. For thy sight shall not live, and be justified. For the enemy and persecute my soul, and yet humble my life down the earth. Yet set me beside me, and he has sat me in darkness, and those that have been. My spirit within me has become a song. Within me, my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all thy works. I pondered on the creation of thy hand, stretched forth my hands unto thee. My soul thirsts after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit, and make the way. Turn not my face away from thee, lest I become like the man that found the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning. For thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk. For unto thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me through thy will, and thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of the right of righteousness, and thy name's sake, O Lord, shall not leave me. And thy righteousness shall not leave my soul, and thy mercy shall not destroy my enemies. And thou shalt cut off all that have with my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, as God of judgment of my servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and the God of judgment of my servant. Thy your spirit shall lead you in the land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who will now and ever, and to the wicked, and the wicked. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O our God and our hope, glory to
in peace, let's pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Pour peace from above for the salvation of our souls, for the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of all your churches of God, and from the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, and to their end, for our Father, and the Bishop of Joseph, for the venerable priests, and the diaconate, Christ, holy, and the people that are. times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, grant us mercy by thy death, by air, for the sake of the suffering, for heaven and their salvation, for those under persecution, for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call in your members, O Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, and beautiful, O Sinner, Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Where hast thou placed him who sitteth on the chair of the throne? kindness, give me thy Lord, or else cry with me, say, O thou who is ever and ever again, as it is raised again, O Lord, glory to thee, both now and ever, let the age of age on him. Thou who didst call thy mother blessed of thine own pure will, and this comes to thy passion, shining radiantly upon the cross, desire to recall Adam, and say unto the angels, rejoice with me, for I have found peace and silver which was lost. O our God, who with this and hath ordered all things, glory to thee.
Verily, life was placed in the grave, the seals were applied to the stone, and the soul was guarded Christ as it was to the king. And the Lord rose, smiting his enemies in an invisible way.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. By thy voluntary death have we found one life, O Almighty, and only Savior of all. For by thine august rising thou hast called all men, O thou who hast destroyed the victory of Hades and the sting of death. Both now and ever, and to ages of ages, amen. Pray, O worthy Theotokos, for the Son of Christ our God, who was willingly nailed upon the cross, and did his rise from the dead, that he might save our souls.
Let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ.
Christ our God.
Lord, blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to ages of ages.
Amen.
The other disciples came in the boat, dragging the net full of fish, for they were
faithful to thy compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin, for I know my iniquity, and my sin is ever before. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before. Thou mightest be justified in thy word, and prevail in all my judge. For behold, thou hast conceived and made me the sins of my mother. For behold, thou hast loved truth, the hidden and secret things of thy soul, and thou mayest be manifested. Thou shalt sprinkle me with incense, and I shall be clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be white as snow. Thou shalt make me your joy and gladness, the bones of the humble, they shall be blessed. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit. Cast thee not away from my presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit. Restore to me the joy of thy salvation, and thy heavenly spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and God shall turn back to thee. Deliver me from my guilt, O God, the God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For if thou hadst desired sacrifice, I have given. Behold, his offerings thou shalt not refuse. A sacrifice to God is both the spirit of the heart that is broken and humble. God will not despise. The good, O Lord, will make the pleasure of thy time. Let the law of truth seem to fill thy heart. Then shall thou refuse the sacrifice of righteousness. The oblation before thy offering. Then shall they offer the Lord's offering.
Disciples Alexander and Asterios of Cilicia. bishop of Chios, Lydia, the seller of purple of Thyatira, and Philippi, Alexis, the wonder worker, metropolitan of Moscow, and venerable Stephen of Pyperi in Serbia, whose memory we celebrate today, of all the saints, ministry to your most merciful Lord. Hearken unto the petitions of our sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Through the mercies and bounties and compassion of thy only begotten Son, with whom the power of God, together with thou, the Holy Spirit, life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thus, emperor Constantine the Great called the first Ecumenical Council.
the Comforter does hold unable to cry out. O eternal Trinity, will in power thou, O Lord, ever bless us.
Thank you.
as true servants of Christ, Father, thy shepherds, sample as all their wise experience, as the shepherds of the flock, and with body zeal stirring up righteous wrath, they wrought righteous judgment, driving off the disease and grievous wound. When with the spirit sleep, they expel them all from the church's ranks, as fallen even unto death, stripping with a vanity past all cure. For the holy fathers were venerable initiates and seers of the divine preaching, from on high teaching sacred mysteries.
Most blessed Christ our God.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Christ our God of exceeding praise, who didst establish our holy fathers, has illumined the stars of water, and through them displayed us unto the true faith. O most merciful one, glory to thee.
Blessed art thou, Lord, the God of our fathers, for thou art just in all that thou hast done.
Wisdom.
The reading from the Acts of the Apostles.
Let us attend.
In those days, Paul had decided to sail past Ephesus, so that he might not have to spend time in Asia. For he was hastening to be at Jerusalem, if possible, on the day of Pentecost. And from Miletus he sent to Ephesus, and called to him the elders of the church. And when they came to him, they said to him, he said to them, take heed to yourselves and to all the flock, in which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to care for the church of God, which he obtained with the blood of his own Son. I know that after my departure, fierce wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock. And from among your own selves will arise men speaking perverse things, to draw away the disciples after them. Therefore, be alert, remembering that for 3 years I did not cease day or night to admonish everyone with tears. And now I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and to give you the inheritance among all those who are sanctified. I coveted no one's silver or gold or apparel. You yourselves know that these hands ministered to my necessities and to those who were with me. In all things, I have shown you that by so toiling, one must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. And when he had spoken thus, he knelt down and prayed with them all.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Again, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee,
up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify thy Son, that the Son may glorify thee, since thou hast given him power over all flesh, to give eternal life to all whom thou hast given him. And this is eternal life, that they know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. I glorify thee on earth, having accomplished the work which thou gavest me to do. And now, Father, glorify thou me in thy presence with the glory which I had with thee before the world was made. I have manifested thy name to the men whom thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them to me, and they have kept thy word. Now they know that everything that thou hast given me is from thee, for I have given them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. I am praying for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those whom thou hast given me, for they are thine, all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to thee. Holy Father, keep them in thy name, which thou hast given me, that they may be one, even as we are one. While I was with them, I kept them in thy name, which thou hast given me. I have guarded them, and none of them is lost, but the son of perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they may have my joy fulfilled in themselves.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
Peace be with thee.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
hear it, one God.
Amen.
Morning.
Morning.
You know, I'm not a doctor, and I don't even play one on TV, but I'm here to offer an opinion. Most of us have a self-esteem problem. And it isn't necessarily that we think too lowly of ourselves, or even that we think too highly of ourselves. It's that we think of ourselves too much. Our self-esteem problem is an obsession. We might say what we really have is a Christ-esteem problem, in that we do not esteem Him as highly and as properly as we should in order to understand the meaning of our own life. You know, you don't understand yourself by thinking about yourself, but by knowing Christ, contemplating, meditating on Him, it's revealed who we are. For certain, we are a fallen and broken people living in a fallen and broken world. But the one thing that saves us, giving meaning to everything, is that we have been joined to Christ. Everything that Jesus Christ has accomplished and continues to experience in His humanity is shared by us, because you know, He's not just an historic figure, some guy who lived a long, long time ago. Jesus lives, right? He's alive today. And His humanity is still undergoing this glorification, and this is still available to us. So it is not just that Christ died for our sins on the cross, but of course, because we're joined to Him through holy baptism, we die with Him. Isn't this what the scriptures teach? You are not united to Christ in His death. And so dying, we endured the penalty for sin, which is death. And we have not only died with Him, the scriptures also say, but we have been raised with Him by His glorious third day resurrection. And so dead with Christ and alive with Christ. But the story doesn't end there. For on the 40th day after rising from the dead, Christ ascended into heaven to be seated in glory at the right hand of God the Father. Our humanity is already enthroned in heaven in the presence of God, His saints, and all the heavenly hosts. So it's not just dogma, nice sounding words, a good story. This is the reality that we so often fail to grasp and make real in our lives. Don't you think it should make a difference if you are already seated at the right hand of God the Father? Wouldn't that make a difference in your life or not? You know? And while we are seated in the high places, so often we go about as if we have no great hope beyond what life brings us today. And very often, life does not bring us good things. It brings us sickness and sorrow and death. It brings worries and fears and hopes that do disappoint. It brings challenges to our faith. If God is good and loves me, why must I suffer? Why am I unhappy? Why must I bear so many wounds of sorrow? Excuse me. Perhaps we should remember that Christ also still bears wounds of sorrow. You know, Jesus rose from the dead and ascended to heaven, still marked by the wounds of His earthly suffering. Even now, glorified at the right hand of God, He bears the marks of the beatings, the nails, and the spear in His holy side. These dreadful wounds in no way diminish His divine beauty or His heavenly glory. They are not blemishes, but badges of victory. For by His wounds we were healed, and He saved us who were dead in our trespasses and sins. He shows the marks still, and will for all eternity, to remind us that even our many wounds will not prevent us from entering the kingdom of heaven. Because you're broken, because you're wounded against the power of God, what is that?
He will rise you up even in that state, even though you are troubled, worried. Jesus said, in this world, you will have tribulation. Did he say may, might, possibly? No. In this world, you will have tribulation. But fear not, for I have overcome the world. What do we think he meant by this when we're going through our struggles in life? You know, oh, such troubles have come upon me that I can no longer believe in the goodness of God. Isn't that our first recourse? Something's wrong with God. Something's wrong with me or my faith. Something's wrong with what I've been taught. St. Peter addressed this centuries ago, so I guess it's not an original thought for us, but he said, beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery trial when it comes upon you to test you, as though something strange were happening to you. For it is rejoice insofar as you share Christ's sufferings, that you also may rejoice and be glad when his glory is revealed. See, suffering, sorrow, that's not anything to be surprised about. That's not, you know, it is no sign of anything except that we are a fallen and broken people living in a fallen and broken world. Troubles, hardships, disagreements, arguments, divisions, you know, wars, everything. This is all part of the experience for us. That's not the surprise, and we shouldn't act as if, well, why is this happening to me? The difference for us is that in Christ, these wounds are transformed into steps, if you will, to heaven. They are transformed into victory. You know, God does not make us suffer. Why do people always say this? How can a good God, blah, 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 fill in the blank? God doesn't make us suffer. Suffering is simply part and parcel of life in this world. It's unavoidable. Nobody escapes suffering, not even God. For when God became man and dwelt among us, he suffered, did he not? And our hands at the hands of sinful men. But in Christ, suffering is transformed to produce glory and great rejoicing. When Christ is revealed in glory, all suffering will be revealed as redemptive. In that day, we will all rejoice in our former sufferings and likely even wish that we had borne more. That's hard to believe. We think, no, my sufferings have taken me to the limit, even beyond the limit. No more for me, please. But on the other side, we'll say, wow, I wish I'd had 1,000 times as much because of the glory that they produce in us through Christ. St. Paul wrote, for I reckon, frozen news from Australia, mate. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. What a wild statement that is. Wild? I'm going to say crazier or wild. The sufferings, I mean, it almost seems to us like he just rushes it off, right? The sufferings of this world are nothing. And we think, well, there's a lot of suffering in this world. A lot of people that need a hug, at the very least, and aren't getting one. But he says, no, compared to the glory to be revealed, it is nothing. In the book of Revelation, he talks about when the saints arrive in the presence of God, there's no more sorrow, no more tears, no more, you know, just sighing, sorrow have all passed away. We think, I don't know, you know, there's an awful lot of terrible things in this world. But the fathers and saints tell us that the glory to be revealed, the glory of God, the beauty of God, it's just going to make everything just evaporate. We will not even remember. Can you imagine a glory so great? We can imagine a suffering so great that we would never forget it. But can you imagine a glory so great that it actually makes sense that we had suffered? And we might even think we hadn't suffered enough. That's amazing. We don't often think that way. But I believe that's the reality. God is much greater than we imagine him to be. Christ died, Christ rose, and Christ ascended into heaven.
And in a few days we will celebrate the Feast of Pentecost, which marks the fulfillment of Christ's promise to his disciples that where I am, there you will be also. Pentecost is the descent of the Holy Spirit and the birth of the church, in which the church, we ascend into heaven to join with Christ in every divine service. We are with Christ. This promise that he made was not empty, and it is not by and by when we enter into the church to worship God. If you can, you know, we can all take a moment from looking around and smiling at the kids and thinking how cute they are and focus on what we're doing. We have ascended with Christ. We are where he is. We are with him, beside him, joining with him. And that will be fulfilled. We dwell in this world, but we also dwell in heaven. And this is the true reality that disperses the fog of delusion that so often keeps us from knowing God, or so often keeps us really just living in that world of confusion. Brothers and sisters, I reckon that we all need to work on our Christ esteem, to elevate our view of Christ and what he has accomplished for us. We haven't been left behind. We aren't just, folks trying to hang on to a bright hope or idea. We have been united with Christ. We have died. We have been raised. And we have ascended. And life is all about Jesus Christ. Christ's esteem. It always comes as a surprise that life isn't all about us. But when we realize everything is and always has been about Jesus Christ, then our lives begin to make sense. There's an old Irish saying that I just made up that says, the humble man doesn't think less of himself. The humble man thinks of himself less. And that's a good point. When we learn to put Christ first in our thoughts and in our life, when we esteem his works highly and believe in them firmly, this is when we are free to think of ourselves less and less and be glad in the great works that God is accomplishing in us through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Glory to God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy charity, wisdom.
That guardian always by thy might we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto ages of ages.
All you, the Lord God, you remember us all in this kingdom, always now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for Kevin, Colleen and their family, for Wanda and her family, for Shelley and her family, for Peter, Christina, and the newborn Joseph, for Brian and Aubrey, and the newborn Matthew, for Michael, Catherine, Bob, Deaconessa, Michelle, for Sophia, Nadia, Angela, and Destiny, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages, salvation. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for Michael, Myron, and for the Deacon Mark, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Let us ask in the Lord.
And his soul.
something good and profitable for our souls, and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
And peace of the Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, a Christian ending to our life, aimless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
And peace of
and right to begin command thee, to bless thee, to praise thee, to give thanks unto thee, and to worship thee in every place of thy dominion. For thou art God, ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing, and eternally the same. Thou, thy only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit, thou wouldst who didst bring us from non-existence into being, and when we have fallen away, didst raise us up again. And didn't not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us for manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry which thou dost vouchsafe to receive in our hands. Even though the standards are the thousands of archangels and a thousand of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring along, born of their kingdoms, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and singing.
Lady of the books, and ever virgin Mary.
holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth.
Precious blood, and through us unto all the saints. the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. And I believe that this is truly an immaculate body, and that this is truly an precious blood. Wherefore I pray thee, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary, of word and of deed, of knowledge and of ignorance, and make me worthy to partake without condemnation of thy immaculate mysteries, unto remission of my sins, and unto life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystic supper, O Son of God, accept me today's communion, for I will not speak of thy mysteries to my enemies. Neither will I give thee a kiss as to Judas, but like the thief will I confess thee. Remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom, not unto judgment, nor unto condemnation. Be not partaken of thy holy mysteries, O Lord, but unto the healing of soul and body.
From the heavens, pray.
involves showing up to church on time. If you miss, let's say, the gospel lesson, then you really shouldn't partake of communion. You need to be here when the church opens.
With the fear of God and faith and love, draw near.
Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. God is the Lord and has revealed himself to you.
Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all thy people. For every good and perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Bishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, especially the 318 of the First Ecumenical Council of Nicaea, whom we commemorate today, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Anna, of the martyrs Thalaleos, the unmercenary healer of Phoenicia, and his disciples Alexander and Asterios of Sicilia, the martyr Asclepius of Egypt, and the venerable Nicetas, John, and Joseph of Chios, Lydia, the seller of purple of Thyatira and Philippi, Alexis, the water worker, metropolitan of Moscow, and the venerable Stephen of Ithura of Serbia, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints. Have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves my God. Prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
This morning, we have our monthly memorial for our loved ones who have passed away.
So, that includes you. As among the relatives.
Hello.
our God, always now and ever and unto ages of ages. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind.
For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God. And unto thee do we ascribe glory, together with thy Father, who is from everlasting, and thine all-holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Peace of blessed Theotokos, who are most holy, save us. Christ our God, and our whole glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, and of all the saints, establish the souls of his servants who have remembered here this morning, who have departed this life, in his holy mansions, and number them among the just, and have mercy upon us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. May thy memory be eternal, O our ever-memorable brethren, who art worthy of blessedness and eternal memory.
Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.